Hello students, welcome to AdiChemistry online coaching. I am AdiChavardhan from AdiChemistry.com. This presentation is an introduction to IUPAC nomenclature in organic chemistry. This is part 1 dealing with systematic formats of IUPAC name. You know that carbon can form millions of organic compounds due to its ability to catenate as well as its ability to bond with other atoms. It can form variety of chains and rings with different lengths and combinations. Not only there are thousands of naturally occurring organic compounds, there are also several other carbon-containing molecules that were synthesized in the laboratory, and the list is ever-growing. It is no longer possible to remember the conventional names based on their source, properties, etc., etc. Hence, the need arises for a systematic approach to name these organic compounds. That led IUPAC, International Union of Pure and Applied Chemistry, to lay down certain rules to name organic compounds systematically. According to IUPAC nomenclature, an organic compound consists of a root word or a word root followed by a primary suffix or suffixes, which in turn may be followed by a secondary suffix. There may be a prefix or prefixes and an infix before the root word. The combination of root word and the primary suffix or suffixes is referred to as base name and it is compulsory. Whereas the secondary suffix, prefix as well as infix may or may not appear in the IUPAC name. The root word or the word root indicates the number of carbon atoms in the parent chain, while the primary suffix or suffixes are used to denote saturation or unsaturation in the parent chain, while the secondary suffix is used to indicate the functional group with highest priority, whereas infix indicates the cyclic or spiral nature of the molecule, and prefix or prefixes are used to denote the side chains, substituents and functional groups with low priority. Okay, now without wasting our time, let us go into the details. First of all, about the root word, it indicates the number of carbon atoms in the parent chain. Different root words are used depending on the number of carbon atoms in the parent chain. Few of them are shown on the screen. For example, if there is only one carbon atom in the parent chain, the root word is meth. For two carbon atoms, the root word is eth. While for three carbon atoms, the root word is prop. Likewise, for four carbon atoms, the root word is but, and so on. Up to 10 carbon atoms, the root words are given. For example, look at this molecule. There are four carbon atoms and hence the root word is but. And for this molecule, the root word is pent because there are five carbon atoms in the parent chain. He is Mr. Weiss, who represents you and will ask questions on behalf of you. Now his question is, what is parent chain? It is a good question. A parent chain is the longest continuous carbon chain containing as many functional groups, double bonds, triple bonds, side chains and substituents as possible. You will learn the details of how to select a parent chain in the next part of this lecture series. Now let us see what is a primary suffix. It is used to indicate the saturation or unsaturation in the parent chain. Now let us see how to give the primary suffixes. When there are only single bonds between carbon atoms in the parent chain, we refer to this condition as saturated and we use "-ane as primary suffix. For example, in this molecule, all the CC bonds are single, hence we had to add the primary suffix "-ane", to the root word "-but". Thus, the IUPAC name of this molecule is butane. If there are double or triple bonds between the carbon atoms, the parent chain is said to be unsaturated. In case of C double bond C, the primary suffix that we have to use is "-ene". Now look at this molecule. There is a double bond between the first and second carbon atoms. Therefore, one "-ene" is added to the root word "-but". Thus, the name is "-but-1-ene". And in this case, the primary suffix is 2-ene because the double bond is in between the second and third carbon atoms. Thus, its name is "-but-2-ene". For a triple bond between carbon atoms, the primary suffix is "-ine". Therefore, look at this molecule. It is "-but-1-ine" and this molecule is "-but-2-ine". A secondary suffix may be added after the primary suffix if there is a functional group in the molecule. The secondary suffix indicates the functional group with highest priority. Let us now try a few of secondary suffixes. If there is an alcoholic functional group in the organic molecule represented by OH, we have to use "-ol" as secondary suffix. For example, in this molecule there are two carbon atoms, hence the root word is "-eth", and there is only one single bond between carbon atoms, therefore the primary suffix is "-ene". Now finally, we have to add "-ol" as secondary suffix since there is an alcoholic functional group. Thus, the IUPAC name of this molecule is ethanol. You may notice that "-e" in the "-ane" is omitted while writing the complete name. If there is a carboxylic acid group in a molecule represented by COOH, we have to use "-oic acid" as the secondary suffix. For example, there is a COOH group in this molecule with two carbon atoms. Hence, its IUPAC name is ethanoic acid. For NH2 group, the secondary suffix is amine. In this molecule, there is only one carbon atom, hence the root word is "-meth". As there is no unsaturation, the primary suffix is "-ene". Now finally, we have to add the secondary suffix "-amine" to indicate the NH2 group. Thus, the name of this compound is "-methanamine". And remember, there are so many other functional groups that you can find elsewhere and use them while naming organic compounds. Now let us move on to the prefix part. Prefix is used to indicate the side chain substituents and functional groups with low priority. Now let us walk through a few of prefixes. This is CH3 side chain represented by the prefix methyl. For example, in this molecule, there is a methyl group on the second carbon. Hence, the prefix 2-methyl precedes butane in its IUPAC name. Look at this molecule. There are four carbon atoms in the parent chain. Hence, the root word is "-but", while the primary suffix is "-ane" because there is no unsaturation here. There are only single bonds between the carbon atoms. And this is CH3CH2 or C2H5 group, represented by the prefix ethyl. And in this molecule, there is one ethyl group on the third carbon. Therefore, 3-ethyl is used as prefix in the IUPAC name of this compound. Here, pent is the root word because there are 5 carbons in the longest possible chain, that is parent chain. And for halogen substituents, represented by X, the prefix is halo. Here, X may be fluorine, chlorine, bromine, or iodine. Therefore, the prefixes may be fluoro, chloro, bromo, or iodo. For example, in this molecule, there is a chloro group on the second carbon. Hence 2-chloro is used as prefix. And this is NO2 group represented by the prefix nitro. And you can clearly see there is a nitro group on the first carbon of this molecule. Hence 1-nitro is used as prefix. It is 1-nitropropane because there is a nitro group on the first carbon. Once again, there is an exhaustive list of prefixes for different side chains and substituents. You can find them elsewhere and use whenever the need arises. Finally, let us see what is infix, which is used to indicate the cyclic or spiral nature of organic compound. For the cyclic compounds, we use cyclo as the infix. For bicyclic compounds, we use bicyclo as infix. And for spiral compounds, we use spiro as infix. I will deal with this infix part in detail in a separate presentation. That's all for now. Visit adichemistry.com for more information on this topic or search for AdiChemistry IUPAC on Google or by using any search engine. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel as well as like this video, share it and write your valuable comments. All the best.